I wish to tell you about the time when me and your Uncle Sammy went to the amusement park. And there we witnessed the deaths of 1,000 kids. Well, as the story goes, we went to the amusement park. Well, for the story to work anyway. We went there, and Sammy, your old Uncle Sammy, he was like, "Man, we should go on a ride." And I'm like, "Ito, why are you crying?" And it was funny at the time. And so we decided to go on the brand new ride because it was really popular. And we got on the ride, and the person working the ride, it was a woman. She was like, "Sirs, you need to put on your seatbelts." And we were like, "We don't need no seatbelts, we adults." And she clearly did not want to be at work that day, so she was like, "Have it your way. Have it your way." Obituary. Oh, check this out. And then, oh, it was so sad. The roller coaster started going, and right as it got to the top, right as it got to the top, all of a sudden, the whole thing just broke apart.
No!
That's what the little kids were like.
No!
And cars were just flying everywhere. And same with the pieces of the roller coaster. And kids were just dropping off all over the place. Your Uncle Sammy and I, we survived by... Well, we were adults, so we lived. But all the kids died. They all fell to their deaths. And the next thing Sammy and I knew, we woke up in a hotel.
Ow.
We had no recollection of the previous day. I still don't even remember what happened. Why am I telling you this story? I don't remember it. But it goes a little something like this.
Hey,
10 hours viewing, like...
the streets of Italy, and all of a sudden, a man with two hands for feet approached us, and he said, "You idiots came to the wrong hood, and now you only have a little bit of time left. Take your belongings and go." And we said, "But Mr. Hands, we don't have any belongings." And he said, "Then go." Sammy was like, "Brother, we can go. The raffle is just about to start. And since everyone is afraid of Mr. Hands, I have really good odds." Just kidding, he didn't say that because Sammy's dead for this story. So it's just actually me been alone this whole time. Mr. Hands on his bluff, and I stayed with my belongings. No, I didn't have any belongings. And within like 5 minutes, the sky got really dark, and all of a sudden, Mr. Hands comes running around the corner, and this time he also has 2 feet where his hand should be, which means he looked normal, if you get what I'm saying. And, he says, "Oh, your time's up, and now you're going to pay the consequences, and they will never be the same." The consequences, that is. And, I don't even remember what he did to me, but I woke up in a basement. And I was covered with baby oil. And I thought, well, I'm leaving. And I did. And now here I am in this bar, telling you this story. You should be in school right now, Sonny. Why didn't Grandpa leave me in his will? I did nothing but nice things for him. and he cut me out. Relax, Bones.
Who are they?
I was taking a walk in the park the other day. This woman approached me, and she said, "Hi, my child died before I did." And I was like, "Well, how do you know? You're still alive." And then she did that thing where, like, she opened her mouth like she was about to say something, and then she just shook her head and walked away. And that day I realized, you know, duck quacks really don't echo. Continued walking down the path a little more. I saw a lake that was filled with ducks, and I thought, it's time to prove this theory right. So I took a duck, and I brought him to a tunnel, but before I could even make him quack, someone came and shot him. And he said, "That's my game, boy." Don't touch that. Do you want to die? I didn't learn a whole lot these days. Thank you.
Woo!
the roof itself isn't haunted, just the inside of the house.
Thank you.
so good textures. I just want to. Scariest ghost, actually.
You couldn't see that, but it was droopy.
Whatever. Stupid rock concerts, get this crap out of here. I ain't releasing nobody. This is my basement. What I wanted to do was kidnap a whole ton of people, put them all in my basement, and then when they'd be like, but we want to be released into society, I'd be like, no. This is society now. You must make your own homes, your own businesses. You must expand my basement to make your own town. Welcome to the future. Some of them will get it. Others will be like, Bokrosted? And that's what they'll say.
I can't expand the basement without my money.
Oh, you don't. Where we are, we don't need money anymore.
I need my money.
No, you don't. That's just useless paper right now.
I have a lot of money.
Not anymore, you don't. We're starting a fresh slate.
I'm taking my money back.
You see, society has gone off the deep end the last few years, so I'm just going to restart it. And it's going to start in my basement. We're going to expand the basement. We're going to keep tunneling underground. Don't worry. I know you guys can do it. You look like a Trex. What world is your vessel? My world, anyways. this. Get out of my way. Why isn't this working?
What?
Old Saint Nicholas's deck on the back of his house. This one has run its course.
Pontoon clouds.
They'll never appear.